Locksley Resources hones its exploration targets at its Desert Antimony Mine, part of its Mojave Project in California. Julian Woodcock is technical advisor. Julian, welcome back to mining.com.au.
Hey, Michael, it's great to be here with you.
Julian, tell us what you're targeting.
Yes, Michael. So we've been working on the Desert Antimony Mine prospect for quite a while, and we have their high-grade antimony mineralization that's hosted within a quartz carbonate vein system that we've been working on with both from surface mapping, sampling, and within there's also some historical adits and workings, which we've recently completed an underground LiDAR survey to map the extent of the workings. And we've been bringing all this information together to publish a maiden JORC exploration target, which we recently announced.
Tell us a little bit more about the mineralization. Do you see any parallels?
Oh, within the mineralization, we have been observing within the vein that we see underground stibnite, which is the antimony sulfide mineral. So that's where the antimony is contained. And that's mineralization we've taken samples of, and we've undertaken some metallurgical test work. What's a really key finding that we've had from that preliminary metallurgical test work is how clean the mineralization is. There's predominantly just stibnite as the main sulfide mineral. We've not really seen any other minerals such as pyrite or galena or which host lead or zinc minerals and things like that. It's a clean material that we're advancing the metallurgical test work, and the purpose of this exploration target is to give us an idea of the potential size that we could hope to delineate through ongoing exploration activities. It is conceptual in nature at this stage. It's based on the information we have from surface mapping and reviewing the underground, but it's a key starting point for us to aspire to grow through future activity.
Julian, tell us about the size of what you're targeting.
Yeah, so the exploration target that we've recently defined has a range in tons from about 770,000 tons to around 1.4 million tons. The grade that we're targeting ranges between 2.5% and 4.9% antimony, which gives us a contained antimony metal of around 19,000 tons to about 68,000 tons. So that gives us a conceptual target within which we're aspiring to define potentially some resources through our ongoing activity.
Julian, Locksley has been putting out really a lot of news. You've been very active there. Maybe you could kind of step back and then talk more broadly about the exploration program that you've done to date and all the moving pieces.
Yes. So the exploration work that we've completed to date is what's fed into helping define this exploration target. We've undertaken so far two field mapping campaigns, which have incorporated activity specifically focused around the Desert Antimony Mine, but also across the broader, larger Mojave Project land package that we have there. It's really important to note that this land package abuts the Mountain Pass mine, which is owned by MP Materials, which is a substantial rare earth producer in North America. In addition to the mapping, we've undertaken multiple sampling campaigns, which have involved rock chip sampling. The grades and the mineralization that we've seen at that rock chip sampling have helped inform us a potential grade range that we feel could be defined and hence inform the exploration target. The underground workings that are there, we've had a couple of trips underground, had a look at that. We've completed an underground survey to give us a spatial location, which has fed into updating the 3D geological model, which we've used to help define our tonnage range. So we've been able to constrain the mapping from surface through the underground workings to give us that target. Our target's been essentially limited to the meters, which we feel is a reasonable vertical extent.
Lastly, milestones over the next 12 months.
Yeah, key milestones and activity that we're working on. So we've got another field mapping campaign about to commence. We recently just completed a helimag survey and radiometric survey. So we're currently working through interpreting that, which will produce as a structural model. That structural model will inform the field geologist to help go and identify areas to follow up with boots on the ground. We're also embarking on a stream sediment sampling program, which will allow us to cover a large swathe of the ground, which hopefully will give us some results that will give us, again, areas to be focusing on more activity. There's also drilling plans, so the El Campo target, which I haven't really talked about in this discussion, but is a rare earth target on our tenure, and we've got drilling earmarked to commence very soon on that. And then also anticipating moving forward to undertaking some drilling at Desert Antimony.
Julian, thanks for speaking with mining.com.au.
Thanks for having me, Michael.